So we've harvested some black locust branches. It has a very tight grain pattern here. So it's very good for carving. Some of these are almost an inch in diameter. And we want to cut these down to about 14 or 16 inches in length so we can end up with some 12 inch or so wands. We're going to use a simple knife and just remove as much bark as we can. So I'm going to be using a belt sander, but I want to show you, even with the simple blade, you can do some basic whittling. It's a much more time-intensive process. You don't necessarily need a special knife. Just slowly take layers off. It might give you a better sense of accomplishment if you do this completely by hand. And just keep working it down until you get the whole thing clean, and then we'll go ahead and start shaping out the shape we want. Obviously, use basic safety principles. So we want to make sure that our cuts are going away from ourselves. We don't want to use paring cuts like this, because there's the chance that we could cut our thumb or cut towards ourselves and cause major injury, especially with a blade sharp like this. I've done a couple with this process. It is much faster if we move on over to the belt sander. So I have the 1-inch belt sander set up with some 80 grit paper on there. And we're gonna go ahead and remove a lot of the material, especially these little side knots.
Thank you.
don't want to go too deep to not remove too much material right away. We're just trying to get this overall smooth effect going on. And again, take down those knots. So I'll speed this part up and we'll take the rest of this wood down. At this stage, I've decided we're gonna go just pretty aggressive on this. So my hand is about here. We're gonna assume we need about this much for a handle. We'll probably lose a little bit at the end in the process, but from here down, we're gonna greatly reduce the thickness here. So I switched the belt up to some 120 grit. We're going to go ahead and work on smoothing out these rings, give this a little more definition, and we can work on bringing down these midsections of the wand and making them smoother. this is what we end up with on one section. You can see how much material we've lost compared to what we started with. Just like any other working project, just remember that you can always take way more material, but you can't put it back. So take your time, work on little bits at a time. We can always work on smoothing this out even more by hand later on. And this is where we're at now. So we have a nice ringed effect going on. It's fairly consistent throughout. We'll go back through with some smaller grit, touch this up by hand. And then next we just need to work on the handle. A couple different ideas we can go with here. Your imagination is the only real limit. So we'll see what we can decide on for that. So I've decided we're going to go with sort of a basket weave design here. So I've taken a pencil and sketched out this into sixths and then drawn up the shaft of the handle, straight lines. I've then made diagonal lines coming down to the left, down one over two, and to the right, down one over one. We're going to go ahead and use the Dremmel and get to work on that. Alright, now we'll take some 120 grit sandpaper and just soften up everything. Alright, these are the three I made after some finishing. This is the one that has the little rings going down the wand and a little crosshatch pattern with some shading. This other one went with a slightly different pattern and the handle's a little bit darker colored than the shaft of the wand. And this other one just got a little bit of oil. It didn't get stained. This was also very aggressively ground down, so that it's a much lighter tip to the wand.